Now that the Mavic Mini is here, which DJI drone is best for you? Let's skip the intro and get right into it. I'm gonna start out by eliminating a few Mavic drones from this list and explain why. Then I'm gonna discuss the four best DJI Mavic drones for different budgets and situations. So first, let's take a look inside the DJI store. The only original Mavic Pro I see is the refurbished and it's out of stock. So let's eliminate that drone. The Mavic Pro Platinum drone by itself is also out of stock, and the Mavic Pro Platinum combo is $14.99. That's not a bad deal considering it comes with three batteries and a few other accessories. It's also DJI's most quiet drone and has up to 30 minutes of flight time. Nevertheless, I would still recommend the Mavic 2 Zoom over the Platinum because it has OcuSync 2.0, better active track, and the ability to zoom from 24 to 48 millimeters and a higher bit rate than the Mavic Pro Platinum. If we take a deeper look, we can see that the Mavic Pro Platinum combo also comes refurbished for $1,035. I think that's a phenomenal deal, but I don't think that will last long, and eventually they will phase it out. And although I have bought a refurbished drone in the past, I know it's not for everyone, so I'm gonna eliminate the Mavic Pro Platinum as well. So now we have our final four: Mavic 2 Pro, Mavic 2 Zoom, Mavic Air, and Mavic Mini. Let's take a closer look at these drones side by side. The advantages are highlighted in blue, and the disadvantages are highlighted in red. The Mavic 2 Pro obviously has the best camera sensor for both video and photography. So for the absolute best image quality, you're gonna want the Mavic 2 Pro. The Mavic Mini is the only drone that doesn't shoot raw photographs. For video, you can see that the Mavic Mini is a little behind the other Mavic drones. Not shooting 4K for me is not a big deal, but shooting at 40 megabits per second is a significant drawback for the Mavic Mini, as the other three drones transfer data at a much higher rate, providing better video quality. If you're looking for a cheaper, more portable drone for video, I still think the Mavic Air beats the Mavic Mini. I personally love the Mavic Air, but it has one big drawback, and that's the max of only 21 minutes of flight time, which in the real world flying equates to about 17 to 19 minutes. You can see the Mavic Mini is also behind the other drones in speed, though I prefer slow cinematic shots, so that's not a big deal for me. And 29 miles per hour is still decent speed for most shots you want to get. Moving on, if you want a drone that can fly far, obviously you want the Mavic 2 Pro or Zoom with a much longer range than the Air or the Mini. Now, I have found obstacle avoiding sensors to be very helpful. So the fact that the Mavic Mini doesn't have any, only using its vertical positioning system for hovering and landing, is unfortunate. Perhaps DJI had to do this to keep it under 250 grams. And that's where the Mavic Mini really shines. It's the only Mavic you don't have to register with the FAA in the United States because it's only 249 grams. It also is the smallest folded up and cheaper by a long shot. It's worth noting that unfolded, the Air and the Mini are nearly the same in size. So with all that said, someone who is on a budget is gonna love the Mavic Mini because despite its weight, the three-axis gimbal is gonna help it achieve smooth footage like its bigger brothers. Now, if you're a filmmaker, go with the Mavic 2 Pro because of its 1-inch sensor and the ability to shoot 10-bit color in D-Log, adding a much greater leeway for exposure and color manipulation in post-production, not to mention better image quality in low light. If you're a photographer, I would choose the Mavic 2 Pro again because of its 1-inch 20-megapixel sensor. I wouldn't recommend the Mavic 2 Zoom as it seems to be a one-trick pony. Sure, it zooms from 24 to 48 millimeters, but with a drone, that isn't really that necessary, and considering that the Mavic 2 Pro shoots in two different 4K modes, both at 28 millimeters and 40 millimeters, it is easy to see why it is worth spending the extra money for the Mavic 2 Pro. Now, people are gonna argue about which small Mavic they should buy, the Air or the Mini. If you want a backup for your Mavic 2 Pro, the Mavic Air is the way to go because its video quality can be edited and mixed well together with the Mavic 2 Pro footage. However, the Mavic Mini with its lower bit rate of 40 megabits per second is gonna lag behind. So I'd spend extra money for the Mavic Air if it's in your budget. With that said, if you're on a tight budget or don't care as much about the absolute best video quality, then the Mavic Mini is gonna be a very good choice. The biggest advantage over the Air, other than its price, is the fact that it can fly for up to 30 minutes, while the Air can only fly up to 21 minutes in ideal situations. So there you have it. Hope this video helps you choose the best Mavic drone. If you want more information about different drones and accessories, I created a free drone gear guide. You can get that free guide by clicking right here. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and share it with someone else. I'm Brett Garamella with BrettGaramella.com, and I'll see you in the next video.